3D fashion design software is great for design, even reviewing the design virtually. But for many designers, the ultimate goal is to create a physical garment. 3D fashion design can definitely help you, but there are a few things you should do to prepare your patterns to be output so they can be cut and sewn into a sample. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I am a digital fashion designer, instructor, and adjunct professor teaching digital fashion design through my company, 383 Design Studio, as well as the Fashion Institute of Technology in New York City. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication on this channel, so if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. When you're using 3D fashion software like Clo3D, which is the software I'll be using in this video, things like seam allowance, notches, annotations are not automatically added. And though they aren't needed to virtually sew a garment on an avatar, they are needed to sew a physical garment. So I'm going to go through how to add those annotations and pattern names, as well as walking a pattern to check pattern lengths and make sure they match, adding notches and seam allowances, and then exporting your pattern. Once your project is on screen, you can hide the 3D window. We'll primarily be working with the 2D pattern, so go ahead and close that other window so you have more room to work. Next, make sure that you're able to see all of your pattern labels and annotations. You can toggle them off or on by going to this menu. You can show or hide the pattern name, annotations, or information you may type on the pattern, line lengths, grain line, and more. Usually the pattern names are hidden by default, and note that if you ever want to change a pattern name or pattern number, go to the property editor and in the information section, you can rename it. Also, just a quick note that you can't customize or control the font or font size for these pattern names or for the annotations. So if you want something specific, you'll have to add that later. For example, exporting the patterns as PDF and then opening them in Illustrator and adding your text there. To add specific information or what's referred to as annotations to a pattern piece, choose the annotation tool, which is the large capital A. Click the pattern to add information and start typing. You can add things like cut one, cut on the fold, the style number, fabric, any information you believe would be helpful for the person looking at that pattern. The smaller capital A tool will allow you to edit the annotation. You can move, rotate, or delete the annotation by right mouse clicking and choosing delete. To edit the text though, you need to go back to the regular annotation tool. The next thing you'll need to do is to check the seam lines of your patterns and make sure that connecting seams are the same length. For straighter lines, you can just click on the line and compare the line lengths, but particularly for curves, you'll want to do something called walking the pattern. This will move the curved line along its adjoining seam to make sure they match and are the same length. This process also allows you to add notches to your patterns. And if you're unfamiliar with what these are, notches are marks you add to your patterns. They're a guide to make sure you match up corresponding seams. They should be located in the same place on the pattern pieces so that they match up when you sew the garment together. As you use the walking tool, you'll not only be able to match the lengths of the seams, but you'll also be able to add your notches. Choose the walk pattern tool and click a point on the pattern you want to walk. Then click the corresponding start point on the pattern seam you want to match it up with. As you drag the red point, you'll see the seam on the walk pattern move along the edge of the stationary pattern. When you get to the point where you want to add the notch, which I usually add near the top or bottom of the seam, but not too close to either and not right in the center, right mouse click. The menu that appears will give you options to add a notch to the walked pattern, the stationary pattern, or both. I usually choose both. Once you've finished walking your pattern, press enter. Besides text annotations, you can also add symbol annotations. For example, If I wanted to add a symbol showing that this pattern will be cut on the fold at center front, I can choose the center front seam line with the pattern symbol tool. And in the property editor, choose the symbol for fold line. This will also work on an internal line. So, for instance, I don't like that the fold line symbol goes edge to edge on the pattern, so I'm going to draw an internal line right on top of the seam line of the pattern and make it a little shorter, and choose that line with the pattern symbol tool. To switch the symbol so that it's on the pattern side, turn the flip option below the line type to on. We're almost ready to go. We just need to add seam allowance. So switch to the seam allowance tool, highlight all of the patterns with the tool, and in the property editor, change the width of your seam allowance. You can also do individual lines. So for instance, if your hems are going to be a little wider, select just the hem lines and update the seam allowance width. For the pattern that's cut on the fold, you won't need to add additional seam allowance at center front, so we'll need to remove that. Select the center front seam line with the seam allowance tool and right mouse click to choose delete. You'll also need to specify the intersection for your hem so that the seam allowance folds correctly. After all of that is done, you're ready to export. For many of you, you'll export one of two ways, either as a DXF pattern or as a PDF. I'm going to demo this by exporting as a PDF since many people will be outputting the pattern at home or even at some place like Staples onto a large format printer. Or if you're a pattern maker selling your patterns on a marketplace like Etsy, PDF is a more universal format. Go to File, Export, Adobe PDF. Name the file and choose where to save it. Then you'll be able to customize what information you want to show on your patterns. In the left section, you can leave the scale, percent, and rotation as is. For margins, give it at least a half inch, and if you know you need larger margins for your printer, set it to a larger width. On the right side, in options for show lines, I leave everything selected except graphic lines and reference lines. Under show images, unless I have a graphic placement on my pattern, I leave both options unselected. And under show additional information, the only things I leave unchecked are line lengths and 2D measurements. I don't need to see any line lengths, and if I want 2D measurements, I'll just check the spec sheet. Then you can open and print your patterns in either Acrobat or in Illustrator. The one thing I didn't cover in this video is the pattern layout. Remember to organize your patterns so they're closer together and laid out more efficiently, so they're not scattered across the artboards like mine were here. It'll make it easier to print the patterns. But if you forget, you can always move them around and reposition your patterns in Illustrator. And if you don't have Illustrator, make sure you do this in Clo. You won't be able to reposition the patterns using Acrobat. Thanks for watching today's video. If you want to start using 3D fashion design software, I invite you to check out my Clo3D course. It'll give you clear instruction and an organized program to get you designing and using Clo3D in days. So make sure you tap the link in the description to sign up today. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.